الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. كنتين إن شاء الله تعالى بسورة النجم and verse number 50، آية number 50 from سورة النجم. سورة النجم هي سورة number 53. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وأنه أهلك عادًا الأولى. وأنه أهلك عادًا الأولى. وثمود فما أبقى وثمود فما أبقى وقوم نوح من قبل إنهم كانوا هم أظلم وأطغى وقوم نوح من قبل إنهم كانوا هم أظلم وأطغى والمؤتفكة أهوى والمؤتفكة أهوى فغشاها ما غشا فغشاها ما غشا فبأي آلاء ربك تتمارى فبأي آلاء ربك تتمارى هذا نذير من النذر الأولى هذا نذير من النذر الأولى أزفت الآزفة أزفت الآزفة ليس لها من دون الله كاشفة ليس لها من دون الله كاشفة أفمن هذا الحديث تعجبون أفمن هذا الحديث تعجبون وتضحكون ولا تبكون وتضحكون ولا تبكون وأنتم سامدون وأنتم سامدون فاسجدوا لله واعبدوا فاسجدوا لله واعبدوا. first three verses we recite them yesterday. وأنه أهلك عاد الأولى وثمود فما أبقى وقوم نوح من قبل إنهم كانوا هم أظلم وأطغى. We talked about that. But then again, a reminder, make sure that we have أغنى أقنى أظلم أطغى. The Hamza is always light. And what comes after it in these four words, heavy letter. So أغنى أقنى أظلم أطغى. And then والمؤتفكة أهوى. والمؤتفكة أهوى. They're all light letters. So easy, inshallah. And the ها أهوى. فغشاها with a شد. فغشاها ما غشا. فبأي آلاء ربك. 4 to 5 counts. ربك تتمارى. The ra with fatha is always heavy. هذا نذير تنوين after it ميم إضغام الغنة من نون الشدة takes 2 counts من النذر الأولى the ra with كسرة is light هذا نذير من النذر الأولى أزفت الآزفة أزفت الآزفة as it sounds like that very clear. But make sure that the mudud is correct. There's no mudud. أزفت الآزفة. ليس لها من دون الله. The إخفاء من دون الله كاشفة. And تاء مربوطة at the end ends with a ها كاشفة. أفمن هذا الحديث تعجبون. And the مد the نون مد because of the نون والسكون. وتضحكون ولا تبكون. وتضحكون the ضاد with سكون وقلقلة the باء تبكون with قلقل. So it's a common mistake that sometimes people say تضحكون. No. تضحكون. تضحكون. Does not bounce back. وتضحكون. ولا تبكون. Say وتضحكون. وتضحكون. وتضحكون ولا تبكون وأنتم ف وأنتم سامدون فاسجدوا لله واعبدوا. The seen is always seen and the jim that sometimes when the seen and jim are together a person tend to make the seen زي or something like that. So فاسجدوا no فاسجدوا. Make sure that the scene is seen, but don't stay there long, but just you stress it so that it doesn't come out something else. فاسجدوا. فاسجدوا. And at the end, فاسجدوا لله واعبدوا. There's no ها, right? Not واعبدوه. So واعبدوا. And you don't make it long because there's no مد here. واعبدوا. Like that. نعم. These ayat, whether it's a continuation of what's in Suhuf Musa and Ibrahim, or in general, this is all things as the wahy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the same. When it comes to the foundation of the deen of Al-Islam, the matters of Tawheed and the Sunnah and the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but it's given in the most comprehensive and most detailed way in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. So after mentioning some of the things about the human beings and how they are under the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and when you put them all together, then the outcome is a very clear when it comes to the full submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Him alone, to rely with one's heart upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, the fear, the hope, everything. All the deeds for Allah, and the same thing with the ibadah, and the entire life becomes an enjoyable one for the believers when they are in a state of submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As you see from where Alla taziru waziratu wazra ukhra, wa laysa al-insani illa ma sa'a, wa anna sa'yahu sawfa yura, thumma yujzahu al-jazaa al-awfa, wa anna ila rabbika al-muntaha. So the purpose of this life, the actions of the human beings, the end of things is to Allah. And even with the things that we see every day, that we witness in ourselves, everything is by Allah. Who's the one that makes a person laugh? And who's the one that makes the same person cry or weep? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He's the one that amata wa ahya. Death and life is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not belonging to anyone. No one has the power of these things whatsoever. And it has to be like this, like when you say La ilaha illallah, that means no one is worthy of worship except Allah. So they always have this negation and affirming, negating that anything is to be worshipped besides Allah, and only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be worshipped. This is how you perfect the tawheed. So the same thing, when these things are stated, it is not sufficient to say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give life and death, unless you deny that anyone else has anything to do with this. Because that's what the verses refers to. So no one can give life or death to no one but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَنَّهُ أَضْحَكَ وَأَبْكَ وَأَنَّهُ خَلَقَ الزَّوْجَيْنِ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ إِذَا تُمْنَى وَأَنَّ عَلَيْهِ النَّشْأَةَ الْأُخْرَى ذِهِ الْآفْتَى وَأَنَّهُ أَغْنَى وَأَقْنَى. We talked about the meanings of أَغْنَى وَأَقْنَى. وَأَنَّهُ رَبُّ الشِّعْرَى, this star or Cyrus or so that the Arabs used to worship. So even that, everything is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the nations before. وَأَنَّهُ أَهْلَكَ عَادًا الْأُولَى وَثَمُودَ فَمَا أَبْقَى. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that destroyed the former عاد الأولى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that destroyed them. So when the disbelievers at the time of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, all of the verses is addressing them, and after stating what we heard, then also it shows the ways of the nations before, that they're not away from it. وَهِيَ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ بِبَعِيدٍ. It is not far from those who are present at all times from the ظَالِمِينَ. What happened to the nations before, it's going to happen to them. The only difference is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam that this ummah would not be destroyed in its totality like the nations before. But the outcome of the punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the same. Imam Sa'di rahimahullah, he says, وَأَنَّهُ أَهْلَكَ عَادًا الْأُولَى وَهُمْ قَوْمُ هُودٍ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. These are the people of Hud alayhi salam. When they kadhabu Hudan, when they disbelieved in Hud alayhi salam, فَأَهْلَكَهُمْ Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala بِرِيحٍ صَرْصَرٍ عَاتِيَةٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them by the wind. And it's mentioned throughout the Quran in Surah Hud, in Surah Al-Fajr, in Surah Al-Haqqa, the like of that. أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِعَادٍ إِرَمَ ذَاتِ الْعِمَادِ. So this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how they were destroyed as a result of their actions. وَأَنَّهُ أَهْلَكَ عَادًا الْأُولَى وَثَمُودَ فَمَا أَبْقَى. وثمود فما أبقى, and ثمود are the people of صالح عليه السلام. As he says, أرسله الله إلى ثمود فكذبوا فبعث الله إليهم الناقة آية. The details of the story is not mentioned here. What is meant here is the fact that one nation after the other are mentioned for people to see that this is the pattern, this is the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in when it comes to the nations. The details are mentioned in other places of the Quran. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to them the she camel as a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَعَقَرُوهَا, they killed it, وَكَذَّبُوا, and they disbelieved in him. فَأَهْلَكَهُمُ اللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them. فَمَا أَبْقَى, that means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not leave none of them whatsoever. فَمَا أَبْقَى بَلْ أَهْلَكَهُمُ اللَّهُ عَنْ آخِرِهِمْ. They were all destroyed. البقاء is to stay. أبقى, فما أبقى, that means, and did not say فما أبقى something, that means everyone was destroyed as a result of that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them signs, and they denied the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and as a result of that, they were destroyed. وقوم نوح من قبل, and the people of Nuh, من قبل, before that, إنهم كانوا هم أظلم وأطغى. They were more unjust and more rebellious and transgressing in disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and disbelieving in Nuh alayhi salam. So وَقَوْمَ نُوحٍ مِّن قَبْلِ. Nuh, this is, so it's not according to the time-wise, because Nuh alayhi salam came before them. مِّن قَبْلِ, before them. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا هُمْ أَظْلَمَ وَأَطْغَى. Indeed, they were أظلم, more unjust and more in transgression from these nations that are mentioned before. And still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them. أن الله سبحانه وتعالى made them drown in the flood that he sent upon them. وإذا أظلم وأطغى Allah knows best. But as the ulama they say in the tafsir, because they lived longer. So their life was longer. The people of Nuh, he called them Da'wa of Nuh alayhi salam, just calling them for ألف سنة إلا 50 عام, 1000 years minus 50 years. And the entire time they are doing ظلم and طغيان. So it's even, if it's correct to say, even though there is no preference of good to evil, you do not say this evil is better than the other evil, but you can say this evil is far worse than another evil. So for someone that commits evil, right, having a shorter life, if he continues to be upon evil till he dies, is better for him than a longer life in evil and injustice. So the more they live, the more punishment they get. And that's also the fact that if they continue to do evil and they are continued to be left to do the evil, this is a bad sign for them. This is not a good sign for them. They would take this as if there's nothing wrong with what they're doing, because the more they do evil, the more they are led to do more evil. So they are led to their own destruction, and the hujjah and the evidence is established against them, so that when they're taken in the worst severe punishment because of their continuous and their evil that they've done. So the people of Nuh, you know, they were adlam and atgha. And that's why it's, you know, if just to imagine people living for 1,000 years, for example. So the person would live in state of kufr. And as it's Qurtubi and others, they say, you have someone is a kafir at the time of Nuh alayhi salam. He takes his son, he goes to Nuh alayhi salam, he tells his son, this is a liar, this is this, and he disbelieves. And the son is a small boy. The old man becomes old, and the young becomes old, and this guy, and the entire lifetime from he was a boy till he dies, old in age, and they're both kuffar, and they stay in the kufr, and their messenger is right in front of them. Messengers, usually a few years, they invite their people, they disbelieve, then the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nuh alayhi salam, for a long time, one after the other, seeing him, and for a long period of time, and that's how they were adlama wa atgha. So as they say, فَيَمُوتُ الْكَبِيرُ عَلَى الْكُفْرِ وَيَنْشَأَ الصَّغِيرُ عَلَى وَصِيَّةِ أَبِيهِ. The older one, he dies on the state of kufr, and the young one, he is raised on the wasiyah of his father, that he keeps on in the state of kufr. وَقَوْمَ نُوحٍ مِّن قَبْلُ إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا هُمْ أَظْلَمَ وَأَطْغَى. And الظلم والطغيان, ظلم, injustice, and the worst injustice is that they worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and الطغيان, transgressing the limits in their actions and their evil deeds and so on. وَالْمُؤْتَفِكَةَ أَهْوَى. And he also destroyed Al-Mu'tafika. And Al-Mu'tafika, there is more than one thing about them, but what's many of the ulama, they refer to as the people of Lut. As the people of Lut. These are the Qura or Mada'in Qawm Lut, the towns of Lut. And it's called Al-Mu'tafika, because it's coming from also the ifk, something that is forged, or something that is lies. So, and also comes from inverted, which is ahwa. Al-Ittifaq is, as they say, al-inqilab, when something is upside down. So, wal-mu'tafikata ahwa. So, whether it's in general, those who disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them, and the nations, the like of them, or it refers to Qawm Lut. And this is what we take from the tafsir here. وَهُمْ قَوْمُ لُوط عليه السلام وَالْمُؤْتَفِكَ. So that's the tafsir of al-mu'tafika that we're studying. Who are the mu'tafika? قوم لوط. The people of Lut, أَهْوَى. That means أَصَابَهُمُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابٍ مَا عَذَّبَ بِهِ أَحَدًا مِنَ الْعَالَمِينَ. He punished them with a عذاب, with a punishment that he did not punish any of the alameen before them, any of the nations before. قَلَبَ أَسْفَلَ دِيَارِهِمْ أَعْلَهُ. He قَلَبَ, that's also from the meaning of al-ittifaq, he inverted upside down their houses to be on the other side, upside down. وأمطر عليهم حجارة من سجيل and he rained on them the hijara, the stones from fire. So they were uprooted, all the villages of Lut عليه السلام, as it's mentioned in the hadith of Jibreel عليه السلام. He said to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, لو رأيتني, that he رفع قوم لوط بمقادم الجناح, with the tip of his wing, one of the wing. Jibreel عليه السلام has 600 wings. From one of the tips of his wings, and you know that if it's a bird or something that has a wing, the weakest point of the wing is the tip of it. So with one tip, he lifted the Qura, all of the villages of the people of Lut. It was not one town. Lift them all the way to the skies, and then made them upside down, made them to fall to their destruction with stones of the fire to rain on them while they are in that state. قلب أسفل ديارهم أعلاها وأمطر عليهم حجارة من سجين. That's what أهوى. الهوية is to go from above down, from higher place down, thrown like this. And that's what الهوى, the desire, takes the person down as a result of following one's desire. والمؤتفكة أهوى, that means أسقط, or he made them fall. والمؤتفكة أهوى فغشاها ما غشا. فغشاها ما غشا, so they there covered them that which did cover. So this is أي غشيها من العذاب الأليم, covered with the painful punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الوخيم that covered them. ما غشا, when it's something like that repeated, that means أي شيء عظيم لا يمكن وصفه, something so great that you cannot explain and to get the reality of it. فغشاها ما غشا. The same when you say القارعة ما القارعة, that means what do you know about القارعة, that means it's something so great that you cannot comprehend how much great it is. So فغشاها ما غشا, instead of saying what specific things that happened to it to show the how severe punishment that they received. فغشاها ما غشا, and الغاشية is the because it covers. والليل إذا يغشى, يغشى means covers. So فغشاها ما غشا, this is from the حجارة, from the stones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent on them. فساء مطر المنذرين, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about them, وأمطرنا عليهم مطر, فساء مطر المنذرين. We sent on them rain, what a worst rain for those who were warned. The details in Israeliyat, how many were they, 100,000 or this or that, we don't have that, so it's sufficient what is mentioned. فغشاها ما غش. فبأي آلاء ربك تتمارى. So the ayah says, in the translation, then which of the graces of your Lord will you doubt? فبأي آلاء ربك تتمارى. This is basically, you can refer to from the beginning of the surah. When it says ما ضل صاحبكم وما غوى, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام was never led astray, and he was never anything except upon what's upright. So then with the ayat that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him see, لقد رأى من آيات ربه الكبرى, that he saw from the major ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then all of the verses that comes after that, then going back, فبأي آلاء ربك تتمارى, which of the آلاء from the signs of your Lord you are in doubt, meaning to the human beings. أي فبأي نعم الله وفضلي تشك أيها الإنسان. He says here in the tafsir, for which of the favors of Allah and His bounty that you have doubt, O humankind or human being. فإن نعم الله ظاهرة لا تقبل الشك بوجه من الوجوه. The favors of Allah are very apparent, very clear, does not take any doubts whatsoever. فما بالعباد من نعمة إلا منه تعالى. There's no ni'mah, there's no favor that the people they have except it's by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يَدْفَعُ النِّقَمْ إِلَّهُ. And no one pushes away a niqam or punishment or disasters or any miseries except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And all of what's mentioned from the favors of Allah, whether it's the best of all favors, is the wahy, and also the different attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the human beings, they receive the benefit of it. So فَبِأَيَّ أَلَاءِ رَبِّكَ تَتَمَارَى. And who's the one that it is addressed by this? It is not the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, because the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام would never doubt the favors of Allah. But of course, it refers to the human beings. And for those who say, since the surah from the beginning is addressing the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام,
So even if it's to be addressing the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, this is a well-known way of speech to the Arabs and maybe to others, that المخاطب is the one that is to be addressed to someone والمراد به غيره. And what is meant is other than him. Right? Because he would never fall into any doubt. So, and which gives the meaning that imagine that if the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, which would never happen, if that happens to him, like for example, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام in Surah Al-Haqqa, ولو تقول علينا بعض الأقاويل لأخذنا منه باليمين ثم لقطعنا منه الوتين ولئن أشركت لا يحبطن عملك. If you commit shirk, your deeds will be rendered in vain. And we talked about that before. Even if the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is addressed by this to show the importance of the Tawheed, that the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام would never ever of course fall into any shirk, but it shows that even if that happens, there's no honor to anyone that commits shirk. So then you can imagine who is less than the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, how they should be extremely warned from the shirk. And as we heard yesterday, Yahya ibn Zakaria fears the punishment of Allah. So why they are in that high status? Because of the perfect fear of Allah that they have, the perfect actions that they were obedient to Allah. But again, the proper or the most correct opinion in this, فَبِأَيَّ أَلَاءِ رُبِّكَ تَتَمَارَى, it refers to the humankind. To the human beings, which one of the ala or from the signs of your Lord and the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you deny. Then the surah ends with these powerful verses, and all the verses are powerful, that all of what we heard, هَذَا نَذِيرٌ مِنَ النُّذُرِ الْأُولَى. This is a warner of the serious warners of old. So هَذَا نَذِيرٌ. So it refers to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. هذا نذير. Here is a warner, which is, as he says, أي هذا الرسول القرشي الهاشمي محمد بن عبد الله. This messenger from Quraysh الهاشمي محمد the son of Abdullah ليس ببدع من الرسول. He's not a new thing or invented way from the messengers. بل قد تقدمه من الرسل السابقين. Came from before him, the previous messengers, ودعوا إلى ما دعا إلي, and they called the people to what he's calling the people to. فلأي شيء تنكر رسالته. Why they are denying his message, then they fall into the same ways of the disbelievers before. And that's also for those who accepted some message and they denied other messages. They're contradicting to themselves. What made them accept versus not accept? It's the same thing. What made them accept a message, it's by necessity would have to make them accept the other message. وَبِأَيِّ حُجَّةٍ تَبْطُلُ دَعْوَتُ. No one can ever refute the da'wah of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. And then he says in the tafsir, أَلَيْسَتْ أَخْلَاقُهُ أَعْلَى أَخْلَاقِ الرُّسُلِ الْكِرَامِ, that his manners is the best of all of the manners of all the messengers before. أَلَيْسَتْ دَعْوَتُهُ إِلَى كُلِّ خَيْرٍ وَالنَّهِي عَنْ كُلِّ شَرٍ. His da'wah is to invite people to every good and to forbid them from every evil. أَلَمْ يَأْتِ بِالْقُرْآنِ الْكَرِيمِ. He came with the Qur'an, الكريم, الَّذِي لَا أَتِيهِ الْبَاطِلُ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَلَا مِنْ خَلْفِهِ. No falsehood come to it from in front of it, the back of it. It doesn't, it's perfect speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing is the like of the Qur'an present in the life of the people. تَنْزِيلٌ مِنْ حَكِيمٍ حَمِيدٍ. أَلَمْ يُهْلِكِ اللَّهُ مَنْ كَذَّبَ مَنْ قَبْلَهُ مِنَ الرُّسُلِ الْكِرَامِ. Didn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroy the nations before those who disbelieved in the honored messengers? فما الذي يمنع العذاب عن المكذبين لمحمد سيد المرسلين. What prevents the punishment from for those who disbelieved in the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the best of the messengers, وإمام المتقين, the imam of the متقين, وقائد الغر المحجلين, and the leader of الغر المحجلين, which is one of the characteristics of this ummah. They come in the day of judgment as with the signs of the wudu. So هذا نذير من النذر الأولى. So who is the nadir here that is meant by what is with the context of the ayat is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him as a warner to mankind, to all mankind. هذا نذير من النذر الأولى. And الإنذار is the warnings, as we heard before. So the warnings are to be taken the way it ought to be, and that means people would flee from the outcome of the warnings by being obedient to Allah. Then the ayat azifatil azifa, which means the day of resurrection draws near. Azifatil azifa. And so this is basically explaining al-inzar. What is the inzar? What is the warnings? Azifatil azifa. So this is a warning that the azifa is very near, that the day of judgment is very near. Azifatil azifa. That means the hour is very near. As he says here, ay qarubat al-qiyama. Ay qarubat al-qiyama. The day of al-qiyama is very near. Wadana waqtuha. And its time is coming nearer and nearer. Wabanat alamatuha. And its signs are very clear. And one of the first sign of the day of judgment is the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام being sent. And from then, the signs have been happening according to even what the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام he said. And it's called azifa because it's near, you know, because it's near to, as when they say azifa al-rahil, that means the leaving is very near. So so this is azifa, that means dana, something is very near. So azifa til azifa. See how strong or how near it is. That it's called al-azifa, it's called the near, and it's azifat. The near becomes near. The near is nearer. The near. Can you call something to give it as a name? The close or the near, which is the day of judgment, it's very close. It's one of the names of the day of judgment, al-azif. So the verb from it, azifat. So that's why it's akrab, as the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, al-jannatu akrab ila ahadikum min sharaki na'li wa naru mithlu dhalik. The jannah is closer to one of you than his shoes, and the same thing for the hellfire. So, and as the fact also for those who have a slight amount of reason, كل آت قريب. Everything that is coming is near. If it comes after whatever years, it's still near. And إذا مات العبد قامت قيامته. And if the person dies, his qiyama is established, meaning the first stage of al-qiyama becomes in dar al-jaza, in the state of al-jaza, not in the state of al-ama. So azifat al-azifa, that means the al-qiyama becomes near. ليس لها من دون الله كاشفة, which means none besides Allah can avert it or advance it or delay it, as the translation says. أي إذا أتت القيامة وجاءهم العذاب الموعود به. If the qiyama comes and the punishment comes unto them, no one would reveal it, relieve it away from them or remove it. يعني ليس لها, meaning القيامة, no, it's not going to be averted, it's not going to be changed. And the punishment in it also, there's no kashifa. So al-inkishaf is when something is lifted away. Something is covered and it's lifted away. So that means it's no one will change it. No one will remove the horrors of the day of judgment. No one has the power of that whatsoever, because everything is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَيْسَ لَهَا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ كَاشِفَةً, which basically gives the meaning that no one can avert it, no one can push it away, no one can escape from it whatsoever. And that's al-kashf, is when something becomes uncovered. So as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, even which one of the meanings of it, that the time of the hour, no one knows when the hour is going to be. And that's why لا يجليها لوقتها إلا هو. No one would reveal the time of it except Allah. No one knows when the day of judgment will occur. Even the angel that is given the permission will give the permission to blow in the trumpet. But this is also one of the meanings of it. So no one will push it away. And no one knows about the knowledge of it. And the warning is sufficient for them. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هذا نذير من النذر الأولى. إني نذير لكم بين يدي عذاب شديد. As the, you know, that أنا النذير العريان. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to the people, أنا النذير العريان. نذير العريان, when someone would run to his people without clothes on to give them the seriousness of the warning. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم tell them, أنا النذير العريان, even though of course he did not take his clothes off. But the people of the Arab, when they because people are not taking warnings serious. People, they become relaxed with warnings. So you have to do something to get them really to understand the warnings. So one is what's going to make them run away and do action and things like this. So he has to show them something that this is not a serious thing. And that's why even authorities, they would imprison someone that would give a warning, a false warning. He will be responsible for this because warnings are not to be taken lightly. So you cannot warn people of some disaster that is going to happen when you're just joking with them. But subhanAllah, you see how the people, they take the real warnings as just lies, or they're joking, or they take it in a relaxed way. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his words in such a way that this is the real warning. This is the warning that needs to be taken. And هذا نذير من نذر وكشف أزفت الأزفة ليس لها من دون الله كشفة. And the verses even goes and continues with how the affairs of the human beings with the warnings, which is يا حسرة على العباد. This is how the misery and the sorrow for the human beings. ما يأتيهم من رسول إلا كانوا به يستهزئون. That means every time a messenger is sent, they make mockery of him. And the warnings, they make mockery of the warnings. And they don't deal with that with any other types of warning. But we'll stop here so that we can continue, inshallah ta'ala, next time with the end of the surah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us benefit from this and to make our hearts alive with these warnings, with the deen of Allah, so that the person would then actions will be according to this and to be steadfast upon it till the last day of one's life. So we'll start again with هذا نذير من النذر الأولى إن شاء الله. صلى الله وسلم وبارك على محمد وصحبه وسلم.